16X, Beaver Creek, finally is at a point where I'm happy to put it onto the public server. Just gonna do a quick little flyover, give a few tips on how the map's set up, some things some people might not know about. Few changes from the 4X, I'll let you guys know those. So yeah, right off the bat, a few small changes to the board. A few concerns some people had was with these scales being a little too narrow, you couldn't fit equipment out. Because when you purchase your vehicles, the spawn points pretty much right where this tractor is in this area. And before, that's the only way out was across these scales, so I took down the fence going from that barrier to there. There was a fence there, I took that out, so now you could lower the barrier by inside these offices, which I'll do. Too fast to walk here. Yeah, just go up to the seat, left click, and the barriers will go down. Another big change I did from the 4X to the 16X is a little bit more of a separation of the trees. They're a little, I wouldn't say they were too tight on the 4X, I think it fit the 4X perfectly, but with the expansion of the 16X, in order to get to the other lands that outskirt the 4X map, I felt like it took too long basically to clear the land, so a lot less trees in these blocks, you can get through them a lot quicker and move on to other pieces of property and open up the land for the farmers. Try to add a little bit more detail to these coastlines, add some rocks. I did lower the water level down a little bit, add a little bit more height to some of these cliffs and stuff. This, I believe, is in the 4X map, so nothing's changed here, but just scroll over it real quick. You can actually transfer grain and most other materials, like wood chips and other things, from one silo, well, into the silo and into another train. So basically swapping trains. I figured that would be something pretty cool to add the ability to do that, because there is only there's two different sell points for each train, but if one sell point is selling for more, you can have the option to put it into that other train to bring it to that port. Probably notice that the water color is a little bit more of a deeper blue. It's not quite native to where I'm from, but it's something a little different. I wanted to add a little bit more action to the water. You can see there's a little bit more ripples in there. Did add a bunch of rocks to the rivers and streams and stuff like that to give it another more detailed look to it. So this area up here, I call it the Highlands. It's a lot of dead wood, a little bit larger, dead pine in certain areas. Good area, so you can do some selective cutting, maybe thin it out, all the dead trees. You know, pretty sure as I get further down here, you'll notice that these pines get a little bit bigger. It's not too huge where most of the equipment can cut it. I didn't want to go too crazy with the large trees. A little bit dry there. up close look, I'm pretty sure this is a bigger tree. So there is, I believe, 5 sawmills that are integrated into the map. You gotta have the sawmill mod in your mods folder in order for these to show up. But they are integrated, so it looks like they belong there. You won't be able to place these mods like this in your own save game, so. Pretty good areas here, you know, you can put a yard or whatever up on the side there and try to make some good little shelving areas to these cliffs to throw a landing in for a yard or do some yarding. A lot of big dead pines in through here, kind of wanted to give it a little like a flooded area where certain seasons this area would flood. You get these areas around the coast quite a bit. This little island here, you can only access this island in wintertime. So this area would freeze and you can drive across with a truck. I figured that would be a little neat area. So this right here, it looks like it's unfinished, but I did this on purpose. Kind of wanted to go for like an old burnt forest look. So it's obviously all dead trees, so kind of an area that's all been burnt out by a forest fire or whatever. It'd be nice to be able to add some like darker textures to the bottom of the trees or whatever, but get the idea. So over here is the other port that's been added in. It's set up a little bit differently than the other one, but basically looks the same. You get 2 entrances through with scales. You can still exit out this side the same way as the other one. The only difference is only 1 sell point for logs. The other one has 2 with a crane. One with a crane, one without, but this one is only 1 right here. Since it was such a little bit higher up over here, I had to make these ramps. Plenty of room to back your log trailers down in there, or drive. You can actually drive down into if you want, and actually turn. So you drive down, and turn off to the right here, and then back up, and still offload with a loader of your choice, or whatever. Still got the sell point here. Some reason the crane didn't load in, but it will load in your game. We got it working on our server, so for some reason it's not working in this career. This is DJ land. A lot of flat land. It is. It's actually technically not flat. We do get small ridges here and there, nothing major, but call it more of a rolling style. I didn't want to make it completely flat, but a lot of farmland, basically cleared land for the farmer. This is another sawmill here, it's integrated into the map. See right here, it's a little bit of a hill, but I can't. Guy won't walk forward for some reason. Much over there, except for the train kind of runs through that area and small trees. There's a few small areas that are opened up like that. I didn't put trees in, but kind of figure it out just where you want plow in some fields for your farm or whatever. Visit this sawmill over here. Sawmill number 4. You can actually sell pallets. As well. I believe there's a wood chip cell trigger somewhere in there. Huge field for your farm. Do what you want out here, basically. I may add trees all the way as far as you can see, but for the server, we just have this all wide open for now. Nice little lighthouse. It does turn on at night. This mountain is basically the same as the Forex. It's pretty neat to actually see the whole mountain. I don't know if you're not familiar with the Forex. It's cool to see a normal size map, actually see the other side of the mountain. The 5th sawmill I actually added to the top here. So yeah, that's basically it, the 16x. So there is mud in this map. I didn't put it in a whole lot of places. Just so you can see these little dark areas here. Those will have mud. There's some vernal pools, I call them, or mud holes out in the woods here. There's one here. Another one there. Small little mud holes. Farm's still basically the same. Yeah, make sure you have your placeable mods in your mods folder in order for these to work. Oh yeah, I did add this fence around this little pasture area. That's new with the 16. Sawmill there, that's the main sawmill that's been there from the beginning. Some more mud in the road here, some rocks. Mudded area there, some rocks on this road. Just kind of testing out how it'd be to make a road with some ruts in it and stuff. Some mud. So yeah, this train actually takes like 15 minutes to ride it full speed the whole way. It's quite a long loop. Might even be longer than that, but I think it's pretty cool how it crosses over itself right here. Yeah, like it's. You actually, put your landing up next to the train tracks. It's all pretty flat areas around the train. So, park it, load it up, and head it off to the sell points. Yeah, that's a 16x. Plenty of trees. 145,000 trees, something like that. Pretty close to it. thanks for watching, and hope you guys enjoy this. Put a lot of time into this map. It's been a while, like, since my last release, but I think it was the time was well put into the wait. So hope you guys enjoy. Thank you.